Hello. Hi. This is Thekla Petridou. Today it's Friday, the 14th of February 2020, and it's our weekly video in English, aka vlog, video blog. Today's subject is a question. Is this love? Of course, today it's Valentine's Day, but being a psychologist, working all these years, more than 20 years with love relationships and marriages, I do not like this festivity so much. I've grown to detest it because in the days back when I was still seeing people in my office, I stopped seeing clients 2 years ago. This was a very, very busy day. Every 14th of February, a lot of my clients, usually couples, they got into huge fights and they had many problems. They used to crash my office or call me or text me, or generally it was not a pleasant situation. And me, myself, I believe that we do not need a special day to celebrate love and love relationships and eros, which is the Greek word for erotic love. Every day can be a festive day for people who love themselves and love their spouse or their partner or their loved ones. So today, I want to talk about the difference between love relationships and the other relationships that we think that they are loving ones, but they are not. How do we tell that our romantic relationship is a loving one and not an abusing one? When the word love is used to disguise anything but love, well, many, many times in my career as a psychologist and as a YouTuber in the last 2 years that I upload daily on my channel 2 to 3 videos in Greek, responding to viewers' emails, that maybe 70% of those are about love relationship problems, I've come to realize that many times we use the word love to describe anything but love. We use the word love to describe addiction, addictive relationships. We use the word love to describe codependency. We use the word love to describe abusive relationships. We might use the word love to describe relationships that are not real, the relationships that can be formed with a con artist. There are so many misguided uses of the word love. The word love, or eros in Greek, erotic love, is very specific. It is something that you feel, something that comes from within, and you do not need to label it. I usually get suspicious when I read an email by somebody who says, "This person was the love of my life. This person was love to me. We were so much in love. We were in heaven." Love is not a superficial feeling. Love is not the same as excitement. Love does not mean infatuation. As humans, we have a tendency to fall in love easily. Most of us, at least. Falling in love is a little bit primitive, because we live in the in 2020 year, but we carry primitive bodies which have primitive instincts in them. One of the basic instincts for human survival is falling in love. And the reason is obvious. We don't need a biologist or even a psychobiologist to explain that. The reason is that our species needs to be reproduced. In no circumstance do I support the idea that love is only for reproduction. I really do believe that in nowadays, modern people, with the advances that Western society and civilization has come to, and I would say that even Eastern societies and Eastern cultures were even more advanced than Western cultures before. I mean, if you visit some of the religions of the East, the ancient religions of the East, you will see that love was mystified and it was celebrated as a way to live life and connect with other people and not purely a reproductive procedure. But it's true that we have the instincts inside us, basic instincts. One of it is to fall in love. It's nothing serious to fall in love, to have an infatuation. It's just hormones. It's just our neurotransmitters working. It's just our brain producing adrenaline, producing dopamine, and producing all these neurotransmitters, all these chemicals that make us feel butterflies in our stomach. This is so easy to happen, and this is so primitive, and this is something not to engage in. What I mean not to engage in? I mean, it's a good idea not to be infatuated by our infatuations. I think that mostly teenagers get infatuated all the time. And even some adults that are sensitive souls and they have clean and pure hearts, they tend to fall in love easily. But that's just the first stage, falling in love or feeling an infatuation, in order to come near a person and meet a person and maybe form a relationship, an erotic relationship, a love relationship. When does infatuation and falling in love becomes love? It becomes after several months of harmonious relationship with the other person and getting to know the other person is in a much deeper level. And after spending the first 3-4 months that the hormones are really high, that our brain chemicals dance a lot in our brain and butterflies in our stomachs, and you can feel after the 5th, 6th, 7th month of the relationship, if it lasts so long, that you have loving feelings for the other person. You feel affection. You feel positivity towards the other person, towards your partner. You feel like hugging them. You feel like kissing them. You trust them. You feel good for them. They feel good for you. They feel well for you. They want to help you advance in your life. You are motivated to stand by them in everyday's problems and bad moments, and join them in the happy moments as well. And a loving relationship is a relationship that allows you to flourish in it. When you are in a true loving relationship, you become prettier, you become more handsome, you glow without makeup on and without the special ring light I have here. You have this natural glow in your eyes, and people around you will tell you, What happened to you? What have you done? What's going on? Love cannot be hidden. There is a Greek saying which says you cannot hide love and cough. When you are in love, it shows. And when you are in love with reciprocation, not just being in love by yourself like some teenage girl, when you are in a loving relationship that you love the other person and the other person loves you. If you are in a position that you are not sure whether your romantic relationship is love or something else, you should worry. You should worry because most probably it's not love. When you have a loving relationship and when you have real love, you feel at home and you are relaxed and you can enjoy everyday life without worrying, does my partner love me? Does he or she fancy me? Are they loyal to me? Do they say the truth? Is he or is she the one for me? You do not have any kind of questions like that. You just go with the flow, and the flow is beautiful. And the flow is like a mellow spring morning, early summer morning, when there is not too much heat, no wind at all, that the sea is like a swimming pool and has this beautiful blue color, and you sit on the shore and you put your feet in the water and you feel warm and relaxed, and you say, oh, this is mellow. Love is like that. Love is mellow most of the time. Love is not mellow when you fight, because loving couples also fight and they have moments of tension and they have disagreements and they might go through difficult times like everybody. But the general, overall feeling is that of satisfaction, of purity, of trust, and the feeling that I am where I belong, without worrying about it. Of course, a loving relationship is not formed from the one minute to the other. You need to go through the dating phase, the flirtatious phase, the phase where you flirt each other, forming the love bond, the erotic bond over time, maybe takes some days or some weeks, that you proceed to having a corporal relationship as well as an emotional relationship. And when you connect and interact more with each other, after the first 3 months, 3 or 4 months, then you can start building slowly the foundation of your loving relationship. This is love. Love is living in your dream house with your dream person. And I use the word dream house metaphorically. Dream home, I would say. When you feel that, this is my life. That's what it's all been for. That's what it's all been about. That's why all my previous relationships or attempts to form a relationship weren't coming out, because all the previous people I met were not my partner. You are in a loving relationship when you have respect, when you have the freedom to say whatever you feel, when you feel yourself in that relationship. You do not need to hide anything from your partner. It's okay for you to be yourself, to be, sometimes you are not so complimentary of self, because we have, all of us, we have our aspects that are not so good. For example, my major disadvantage is that I get very angry. When I get angry, I get loud, which is not something nice for my husband to endure. But because he loves me, he can love me all around, even including these rare days in the month when I get very angry. And to be totally honest with you, also my husband has his own disadvantages. For example, he can be very, very passive aggressive. I mean, he can get angry with something, not express it out loud, and it can stay inside him. Then I sense him. I sense that there's something going wrong, and I ask what's wrong. And he says nothing is wrong, and I say what's wrong? Nothing is wrong. And then I get angry, and then he also gets angry, and then we find out what's wrong, and then we resolve it, and then we move on. Everybody have good parts of their personality and some not so good parts of their personality, but on an overall picture, when you love yourself and you love your spouse and you love your partner and you try to be the best version of yourself, and you have this urge for spiritual growth, then you can feel at home with not your perfect partner, not so perfect partner, not so perfect lover, who loves you and loves him or herself and your relationship. I wish to all of us today that it's Valentine's Day, which I do not celebrate, but I wish, because some of you might, to have a loving relationship with ourselves in order to be able to have loving relationship with our other half. And if you are in an abusive relationship or a relationship that does not make you feel happy, free and fulfilled, please review your relationship. Please ask the assistance of a mental health professional, maybe a counseling psychologist or a therapist, to help you sort out the issues with your relationship, because you cannot enjoy life when you are in an unloving relationship. I wish you the best. Bye. Have a lovely weekend, everybody. If you liked my channel, please subscribe. Put a thumbs up if you liked it, or a thumbs down if you don't like it, but please explain why you didn't like it. And if it's about my English, I speak English as a secondary language. I'm Greek. I'm Greek Cypriot. I'm Thekla Petridou. Have a nice weekend. See you here next Friday. Bye!